So I'm Alice and I'm a research and documentation assistant at Holland East Riding Museum, working with our archaeology collections. And today we've got a bit of a craft for you. So we're going to be looking at one-to-one scale drawing, which is a technique that archaeologists use to record their finds. So what you're going to need today is a pencil, a ruler, an eraser for if you make any mistakes, and of course a piece of paper. You could use plain paper like I've got, or if you've got squared paper or graph paper, that might help you a little bit more. So whatever you have available. You're also going to need to find a nice object to draw. So this is something I got on holiday. It's a replica of a Venus figurine from the Neolithic period in Orkney. So I'm going to have a go at drawing this today. So the first thing you want to do, get your piece of paper, pop your object down, lie it flat, and then you want to use your pencil to dot around the object to create your outline. Now make sure you don't hold your pencil so it's slanting underneath, because we want to have this as an accurate measurement of the actual object. So it needs to be as vertical as you can get it. So you hold on to the object tight and then dot down, dot, 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 round you go. And now I'm going to show you one that I've done earlier just to speed things up. So then you'll have your dotted outline. Now it's probably a little bit faint for you to see here, but I promise you it's here going all the way around the edge. And then the next thing we do is create that outline. So we want to join up all those dots. So start drawing round. And again, here you can see, here's one that I did earlier. So hopefully by now you've got a nice outline of your object. As you can see, I've got mine here. So the next thing is we want to start adding in some of those details. So this is an exact one-to-one scale drawing. So it's exactly the same size and shape as my object. And you can see here we've got some little details on. So you can particularly see these two circles on the front of the object. So I'm going to try and mark those on. So what you want to do is have a look at your object, see the feature you want to mark, so this circle here, and then you need to measure to a fixed point on the object. So we need to measure down to the top of the circle, that's 4 millimeters down, and then we measure in from the side, that's 5 millimeters across from the side edge. So then I go 4 millimeters down, make a small mark, and then 5 millimeters from the edge, make another small mark. And then you do that for each of the different parts. So wherever the line on the object changes direction, you want to be making a little dot. So again, you can connect all of those dots up. So you have a go and I'll have a show of what I did earlier. So here you go, you get end up with this. Again, it might be a little bit faint for you to see on the piece of paper I have here, but I've now got those little 4 dots to make up that circle. I'm just going to connect them up together. So here you can see I've connected them all up together. And then you continue doing that for all of the different bits that you can see on your object, all the little bits. And again, you can then start to use shading. So if you want, you could just make it a little bit darker to indicate that change. So you can show that it's an indented thing. So again, just showing you that object, you can see that it's a little bit indented in. And you just want to show those different changes in your drawing. So you keep going, and if you do finish your drawing, please do send us copies of them. And we'd love to see what you've done. So tag us in either on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. And as you can see from my final drawing, from doing things like one-to-one scale drawing, you really look at those objects a bit more carefully and you start to notice things that you maybe wouldn't have noticed if you'd taken a photograph. So like with this object, you know, initially you just see those 2 big circles which were clearly marked and meant to be there. But then when you look more closely and you see on my drawing, there are all these other lines that were made from when the person actually made it and carved the object. And they're things that you probably wouldn't have focused on quite so much in a photograph. So hopefully you've enjoyed doing this activity and you'll come back and see us soon.